Hello space cats and welcome back to my channel. Characterizing exoplanet satellite. That's what Cheops stands for, and it will finally be launching on a Soyuz rocket from ESA's spaceport in French Guiana next week on the 17th of December 2019 after several delays. So what's up with this mission? Cheops is an S-class ESA mission. That means it's a small budget mission and it's going to cost no more than 50 million euros. The mission is a joint partnership with Switzerland and it's going to go to a sun-synchronous orbit with an altitude of 700 meters. This means that it's going to orbit the Earth at 700 meters above the surface in an almost polar orbit such that the inclination of the orbit with respect to the equator will be about 90 degrees. And its orbit rate is going to be about the same rate that the Earth moves around the Sun. Essentially, it's locked to the Sun. This allows the rear end of the spacecraft to be constantly pointed at the Sun at all times. And this is really important because it minimizes the temperature variations, it minimizes the amount of stray light entering the telescope from the Sun, and it's also optimal for uninterrupted observations. Cheops has just one scientific instrument on board, and this is a photometer that measures the intensity of light from the stars in the visible and near infrared wavelengths. To date, there are 4,099 known exoplanets, planets that orbit stars outside of our solar system. The primary task of Cheops is not to search for new exoplanets, but instead to make new transit measurements of bright stars that are already known to host a planet. To do this, Cheops's photometer makes very high precision measurements of the variation in this star's light. Because when a planet moves in front of its host star, it will block out some of that star's light and it will be dimmed. This is what we call a transit. Some of these exoplanets might already have transit measurements, but Cheops will be able to get even more accurate transit measurements. The transit of a star can tell us a lot about its exoplanet. The depth of the transit tells us about the radius of the exoplanet, because a very large exoplanet will block out more of its star's light. But since planets are typically much smaller than the host stars that they orbit around, typically this dip in the light will be of order 0.01% of the total light of the star. It's really difficult to measure. If we also know the mass of the planet, we can calculate the density of the exoplanet, which can tell us about the composition of the exoplanet, whether it's very rocky like our Earth, or if it's very icy and gaseous like our Jupiter. Also, we can learn about whether or not it can support an atmosphere. The time between the dips, between the transits, gives us the orbital period. This is the time it takes for a planet to orbit around its host star. And if we can combine this with the mass of the star, then we can use Kepler's third law to calculate the orbital radius, which is the distance that an exoplanet orbits around its star. This is a really important parameter because an exoplanet that orbits too close to its star will be way too hot to host liquid water or to host life. And an exoplanet that's too far away from its star will be too cold for life to exist. ESA's Cheops mission is not the same as NASA's exoplanet mission TESS. TESS is staring at 200,000 stars to find new transits, and it has a much shorter observation time, so it's not going to be as good for looking for long period planets. It has less precision. For a 10th magnitude star, it can detect a transit depth of 60 parts per million, compared to the 20 parts per million that Cheops will achieve. This means that Cheops and TESS are complementary to each other. Cheops would make the ideal telescope for follow-up observations of interesting objects that are found by TESS. So another really cool thing I find about Cheops is that part of their outreach campaign, they launched a drawing competition with the theme of the universe for children that are living in ESA member states. 2,748 of these drawings were selected to be engraved on two titanium plates on board of the spacecraft, and now they're getting ready to go to space. The Cheops launch is going to be amazing, and I can't wait to watch it. Let me know if you have plans to watch it too. I'll put some extra reading material down below. But in the meanwhile, if you enjoyed my video, please don't forget to leave me a like, share, and subscribe.